Life after the Olympics is different for every athlete. Some keep playing professionally, others work. For 2008 water polo Olympian Cammy Craig, it was just back to school, right here at the University of Southern California. Cammy let us catch up with her for a day in the life.
Hi, welcome to my house. Come on up. This house was actually a part of the 1984 Olympics. I live in the original Olympic Village, which was kind of cool coming back from the Olympic Village in Beijing and moving into here. We also have another USC Olympic athlete, Amy Rodriguez, who's a soccer player who actually lives here. So it's kind of cool. We'll go ahead and start in the kitchen. All my roommates painted everything and decorated, which is really cool, but pretty simple, pretty college style kitchen. We're big pancake makers, so we like to make pancakes during game day and whatnot. I have four roommates, and this is what a fridge looks like for four roommates. Lots of milk, some juice, Red Bull for those late nights of studying. About it for the kitchen. This would probably be the place where we all just kind of lounge around, talk to each other, catch up on our nights, our days, stuff like that. Big comfy couches. We're always eating out here and just hanging out with our friends. Lots of pictures of our teammates and stuff hanging around. Everyone in this house is pretty much a surfer or a lover of the beach, so that's where most of the theme of the decoration came from. And the room off the living room, so we come on in here. Most important thing about my room is that it's super comfortable. I got the nice big fluffy bed because sleep is very important as an athlete. Pictures of all my good friends, family that I love. Lots of pictures of me and my best friend, me and my mom. Here's a picture of our team that won the Pan American Games. That was a pretty awesome moment. We qualified for the Olympics 2007 in Rio de Janeiro. So I usually sleep with this under my pillow, but I'll bust it out for you guys to see. Here's my medal. I keep it with me at home with me. I know a lot of people send it home with their parents, but this is something very special to me and one thing I couldn't really give up and be like, oh, here, Mom and Dad, will you just throw this in the trophy box? You know, it's something very special, and felt that we spent the whole year working on it very hard, and it's kind of nice to have around when people come around and it's like, oh, they want to see it, and it's like, yeah, I have, and they can't believe it. So, you know, you can make anyone's day with busting it out. So it's very cool. One of my favorite pastimes is surfing, and my very cute boyfriend right here, he likes to surf with me, and that's really fun. We get along and do a lot of cool things together. Here's another great picture of us surfing at our favorite beach. Oh. You're the meaning in my life. You're the inspiration. You bring feeling to my life. You're the inspiration. So this is one of the best gifts that ever been given to me. It's for my 21st birthday. I turned 21 July before we took off to the Olympics, which was probably not your average 21st birthday. It was pretty mellow. The girls got together for me, but there was definitely none of the 21 festivities. But this was a brand new surfboard that my mom and my boyfriend got in and bought for me, and they went ahead and got the rings painted on the board for me. So, you know, it's very, very cool. 21st birthday present, and symbolic because I went to the Olympics that year, so very special. So that was my house. Off to school now. Go get some lunch and start with weights in class.
Thank you. teammates at the Galen Center, and this is kind of like the usual hangout for lunch that we all meet up between classes and grub down on some good food. This is Tamua Nye, she's my goalie. This is Erin, my roommate. Callie, she plays on the team with me. Pharrell Davies and Stephanie Lavien. Some of the usuals, good stuff. We're here in the weight room, just going to do our weights before we have afternoon practice today. And we usually do weights Monday, Wednesday, Friday, so.
I'm fergalicious,
so delicious.
My body stay vicious, I be up in the gym, just working on my fitness, he's my witness. I put your boy on rock, and he be lining down the block just to watch what I got. So delicious. It's my house, so delicious.
Caprillion Hall, better known as the CAP building for the soc majors. I have a lot of classes in here since I'm a sociology major, and I'm about to go into my social psychology class, learn how to read people and whatnot, so it should be good. So I just got done with my class. It's pretty good, feel enlightened, feel like I got my mind working and everything, so now it's off to practice. At McDonald's Stadium. This is the pool where we really put in our hours, the daily grind, some may say. You know, just swimming, working hard out here, doing leg sets, practicing long hours, you know, taking care of our business in this pool, and this is where I spend the majority of my time. You know, it's a great motivator looking up here. We have our banners of our NC2A championship won by our men and women. And you know, you're going through a hard set, a hard swim set, a hard leg set, you're really pushing yourself, and it's cool to just look up there and know that people before us have won it, and that's where we want to go. We want to get to that NC2A championship game and, you know, play our best and play our game. So
watch it. Right back. Rest. No fall. Rest. Side. No pop.
It's a great honor having Jovan as a coach, as you can see through what you guys saw today. He's done a lot for our program here, starting water polo and whatnot, and has won plenty of championships and continues to bring up great teams. So it's an honor to play with him and for this team. All right, thanks for spending the day with me. Day in the life of Cammie Craig, that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching.